25 minutes after the hour of 12 o'clock. In my editorial, I wish to discuss issues concerning Winston Gypsy Peters. I also intend to discuss issues dealing with Jack Warner. And I also intend to discuss their bareback leader, Rowley. Winston Gypsy Peters, former member of parliament for Mayaro. Yesterday, he held a press conference at the Hyatt Regency. And time was given to him to ventilate his stress, his frustration, to burn out the heat within his psyche, even to say all manner of things against the goodly lady, Prime Minister Kamala Prasad Bisesa. And yesterday, he also tendered his resignation as a minister and as a member of the UNC. And what is the salient reason for Gypsy tendering his resignation from the UNC? All because the Prime Minister did not give him a seat to fight. All because the UNC did not allow him to return. All because he is not a candidate of the People's Partnership. Now, we are all human beings. Can I gravitate to the analysis of the bareback leader and support his reason for inviting Gypsy Peters to come and join the People's National Movement Party, all because he did not get the nod to be the candidate for Mayara? Now you see the level of hypocrisy in the People's National Movement Party. That same bareback leader, Rowley, rejected a lot of aspirants who wished to be candidates under a PNM banner. Penelope Beckers came before the screening committee with a majority of party groups from Arima in front of Garcia. But Garcia was given the nod. To this same living day, Penelope Beckers is still a living member of the People's National Movement Party. Myself and Barry Garcia, we have issues with the leadership of the party because it is filled with a bunch of treacherous people. Among some of them might be good people with good intention. But for Gladiator, I have issues with the leadership of the PNM party. But it is not a criteria for me to leave or resign from the PNM party. Here it is. Winston Gypsy Peters is giving the world under the impression that the seat that he went up under a UNC banner belongs to Winston Jepsy Peters alone. And that the seat does not consist of UNC voters or people or persons or constituents that are against the People's National Movement Party. What make you feel? Yes, you, Winston Gypsy Peters. What make you feel that you have a deed from a arrow? What make you feel that Adam or Eve of the Old Testament left a deed for you to be the sole owner, property owner of Meow? That no one could tell you, this time is not your chance, someone else must have it. Basio Pande went to Vancouver North for several years under different names of political parties. But Basio Pande does not have a deed for Vancouver North. No candidate, including the leader of any party, has a deed for any constituency. And your reason for you to rant and rave and misbehave and to align yourself with a corrupt, nasty, lying tongue leader, Jack Warner. Yes, I'm coming to you just now. It's all because you did not get the nod. In your press conference yesterday, yes, you, Winston Gypsy Peters, why didn't you tell the public that had the Prime Minister, had the leader of the People's Partnership granted you permission as the candidate, you would have lost this seat because the people in the area stated they don't want you. You became haughty. You became arrogant, just like Rowley. But you want to bully yourself. You can understand the English language. No is no, or no means no. But you see, you have a sidekick. You never had your party to your heart. Myself and Barry Garcia, we hold the PNM's party dearly and sacredly. And that's why anybody, irrespective of their being the leader of the party, if they try to bring down this party, the PNM party, we're going to say it like it is. But it is not a criteria for us to leave the party or to resign from the party. So you want to tell young people who are watching on and who are looking at you, you want to tell them at any time you don't get in nod as a candidate, the option, the only way out is for you to leave, resign from the party, and then cuss up the leader and say all manner of things against the leader. No, Gypsy. You have joined with a disgrace individual who have fallen from disgrace, who have fallen from grace. Austin Jack Warner. You have joined with a fraudster. You have joined with a thief. You have joined with a liar. And I have the documents here. In the matter involving Faik Mohammed versus Jack Austin Warner. A judgment was delivered against Jack Warner. And you see, the citizens are not aware of this judgment. Yes, you, Jack Warner. You see, your mission is to tarnish and damage people's reputation. On page 39 of the judgment, the judge stated, what is striking in this case is a high-handedness and oppressive nature of the attack by Jack Warner, the defendant. He used music trucks to blare message in the village and directly in front of the claimant's home, Farik Mohammed. Jack Warner made the remarks before the election of the mayor to put pressure and to intimidate Mr. Mohammed. Mr. Warner unrelentingly went on talk show programs. He stated quite casually that he had the proof. However, these were all attempts to deflect from the controversy of a conscience vote from within his own party and to inflict maximum level of hurt on Mr. Mohammed. This is the same thing that he's doing currently to Kamla Prasad Bisesa. His pocket is deep and he's not concerned whether you have been damaged. He go and swear on affidavits, lies upon lies upon lies. This consummate scumbag, yes, you, Jack Warner, this consummate scumbag will pick up a vagrant from off the street if he only hear a whisper to the benefit of his ego to tarnish and damage people's character. In this case involving Farik Mohammed, he thought that he would have won the case. He wanted to play with rough and tough. He decided to appeal the matter. But at the end of the day, he had us a dig in his pocket and sign a check paying Farik Mohammed over $200,000 in damages. I mean to say, Gypsy, is it that politics have reached a level that if you don't get the nod to be a candidate, the only option for you or for anyone is to resign from the party? What manner of example are you setting? History have recorded from since the day of independence in 1962, many persons who vied to be candidates were not selected. And not because they were not selected. The only option for them was to pack up their jaji bundle and leave the party. What manner of example is that? And this is what Dr. Keel, this is what this bareback Rowley is telling people. No shame, reckless. This bareback man mount a platform and is saying to Gypsy, the PNM welcomes you into the party. A man who sat there over the years, never condemned the Prime Minister, never condemned any other member in the party, but all because he did not get the nod for that seat in Mayao, he find all justification to say all manner of things against the Prime Minister.
Right.
And his declaration is that the People's Partnership must not win the election. And when you are asked, when you are being asked by voters, by constituents, why a change of heart against the Prime Minister? All you could tell people, well, I didn't get his seat. And that's why I'm saying that. That is why I'm saying that. According to the High Court judge in the matter involving Faik Mohammed against Austin Jacquona, Mr. Mohammed, Faik Mohammed, was falsely accused of being corrupt, and there is no factual basis to allege that he was paid $2.5 million as alleged by Jacquona. You see, this liar, this scumbag, Jacquona, yes, whenever a court deems you to be a man without credibility, your entire name is scarred for life. But you mount platforms after platforms every week, pontificating as if you are a man fell from heaven, and you now come on this earth, and everything that comes from your mouth is gospel truth. You are a liar. What is so sad, three Africans, Winston Gypsy Peters, an African, the scumbag, the thief, the liar, Jacquona, an African, and the bareback liar, yes you only! Only jumping and trembling your nipples, half naked before Anika Gams are coming for you just now too. You want to be the next Prime Minister, dressing inappropriately before a journalist, trembling your nipples, and that's all what you can offer, and that's all what you can market. And tell people your life is an open book and wants to be the next Prime Minister of this country. You hold your horses here, are coming for you. The time has come for you to be exposed. All three of you, three Africans, what are you all offering to the black community? What example are you all setting to the African community? One, Gypsy Peters, he ain't get no seat at all because he feel he have the deed from Ayaro. Not concerned about political party, not concerned about the constituents in the area, but he have the deed from Adam. He has the deed from Eve of the Old Testament of the Bible. That seat belongs to Winston Gypsy Peters and no one else. You went up under a UNC ticket and the people in that constituency voted for the UNC. Your name happened to be used as a candidate for that given constituency. But how can you change the tune of politics at this given time? How How can you go and tell the public that anytime you don't get a nod as a candidate in a party, the only way for you is to resort to holding a press conference and resigning from the party? Where's the morality? But then you have two persons there who want to buttress your folly. You have the bareback man who has no shame, but wants to be the next prime minister of this country. You have the bareback man. You gypsy, let me deal with you. You my friend. Many times I have been invited to listen to the platform, the partnership platform. But what you're not telling the people, what you're not telling the people, the voters said they will not vote for you. So you want the prime minister. You want to blackmail the prime minister. That's what you want to do. That is what you want to do. Blackmail the prime minister. If you don't give me the seat, I will resign from the UNC and I'll call a press conference and I will tell everybody me and Rowley was always friends. Me and the bareback man was always friends, trembling his nipples before Anika Gums. Let me come to he now. Does this ring a bell? Yes, you, Rowley. Done deal with them others already. Let me come to you, the bareback leader. Does this ring a bell to you, Rowley? I knew him since I used to go to school. And to tell you the truth, I always used to like him since I going to school. But that's just... It used to be a secret something. Does the name Roslyn Allen ring a bell? Yes, you. The man who liked to tremble his nipples and remain bareback in front of a guest to his residence. Cannot tell the nation whether Sharon Rowley wants to divorce you. You can't tell the nation that at all. We want to know. We want to know that there's a harmonious relationship with you and Sharon Rowley. We want to know if she's living by herself at an apartment. We want to know whether Sharon Rowley is living by herself in an apartment. We want to know if you are living by yourself in Glencoe. Yes, you, bareback leader. And I want you to tape it. I want Faris Alwari to tape it. I want Michael Kwamina to tape it. I want Short Young to tape it. And And I want the bald rasta to tape it. All his lawyers. Gladiator ain't no lawyer at all. Did you be a back leader? Did you have sex with a teenage girl by the name of Rosalind Allen some years ago? Did you have sexual intercourse with a teenage girl? Yeah, you want to open your arms and welcome Gypsy. So people who cussing up their party, people who vex that they ain't getting nothing because they were not selected to be a candidate, you mount a platform and say your arms are open and you're welcoming them in the PNN party. That's the level that you have descended into. Condoning mischief. And the message that you are sending to party membership is that whensoever you are not pleased and you did not get the nod in any party, leave the party, resign from the party. That's what you condone, normally. Be a back leader. We want to know whether you, Rowley, had sex with a teenage girl. And should that be a criteria for a person who had sex with a teenage girl to vie for the highest office, one of the highest office in the land? So you want us to ignore that? And you want us to say, well, nothing wrong with that. It's a norm. A school girl. Was Rosalind Allen going to school? Was Rosalind Allen still going to school? The Hmong platforms, you hear them talking. The chairman of the party, Franklin Khan. You hear other person introducing you as the next speaker on the platform. And then we got a whole list. But at no time in the list do they make mention of you when you were a school teacher. In 1991, you lied to the population. You, nasty liar. And you told the population that you only have two children, two daughters. At no time you told the nation you have more than two children. We want to know whether you have five children or more. How many bastard children you have? Yes, you, bareback leader, Rowley. I mean, it says citizens of the republic. I received so much of calls, phone calls, from PNM members. They messaged the Gladiator. They called the Gladiator. Gladiator, you have to speak and do something about it. And I listened to this bareback leader have the audacity to Monkey Platform in San Juan. And people are in shock to hear you saying, the arms, what? Your arms are open for Gypsy and others? They are welcoming the PNM party? What manner of example Gypsy have to offer to members of the PNM party? What manner of example? Is it that you, Rowley, is accepting the new trend that when you are not selected as a candidate, hold a press conference, resign from the party, and try to cuss up the leader? That's the new trend that you are setting? And people saying to give you a chance to be the prime minister of this country? You gotta be mad or what? You got to be mad or what? On April the 21st, Anika Gams went to the St. Joseph police station to complain about prank calls. Before I go there, let me read this man who likes to preach on the platform, say things, call on citizens to be people of moral standing, but don't like to practice what he preach. According to Dr. Rowley, tonight I told you I want to speak to you about morality in public affairs. According to Dr. Rowley, no, what? According to the bareback leader, morality in public affairs means when you put yourself up to conduct public business, you have to subscribe to the principles of morality and ethics, even if they are not written in law. So, some law has to be written to tell you, keep your clothes on. Some law has to tell you that when you have a guest at your home, keep your damn clothes on. Somebody has to see your muscles. Anika Gums has to see your nipples. Good Lord heavens. She has to see what? Your belly? Your six packs? How many inches are those six packs? And how big is your nipple? Consummate liar. A man with bastard child. God Allen, you! But want to be, look. I'm coming back for you. I'm coming back for you! The bareback leader are coming back for you. Damn political rat. But you want to be the prime minister.